Hey guys! Welcome back to architutors. In this Rhino tutorial, we will try to create a parametric wall design in Rhino. Whether you're an architecture student, designer or a professional, these steps will be helpful for you to work in rhinoceros. Let's begin! We're going to start by creating a rectangle in Rhino. In this tutorial we're using Rhino 8. Next, we can create curves that will be the base for our design. We can alter the shape of the curve using the points on the curve. I'll be using 4 different curves for this design. You can also rebuild the curve if necessary by using the command rebuild and redefine number of segments for it. Use tween curves command to create an intermediate curve between 2 curves. And I will copy this intermediary curve to create another curve. Once we have created all curves, we can trim out the line in between these curves. What we want to do here is to create curves on the side to later loft into a 3D surface for the design. We can set the plane on side and use object snap to have a point to snap on the end of the curve on either side while setting up the working plane. Define all axes of this working plane. And now we can use curve tool to create a curve using points on the side. We can keep the object snap option on to help us pick points. If you're keen in watching more of such videos and upcoming tutorials on Rhino and Grasshopper, then make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell icon for all the latest updates. Your viewership means awful a lot to us. Use gumball to move the point segment on the curve. Do the same for the other side. Set the working plane on the side and create curves. Now that we have set up curves, we can create 3D surfaces using these curves. Select the curves and use sweep command to create a 3D surface. Do the same for the rest of the curves. And to create a plane surface on the rest of the model. Select the curves and use command for planar surface. That's how we can create 3D surfaces from defined curves in Rhino. Next, we can select these surfaces and use the command join to join all of them into a single geometry. Use the command select curve to select all existing curves in the model and delete them so that we have only 3D geometry in the project. Use duplicate border command to make a curve around on the border of our geometry. We're going to extrude this border into a surface using gumball extrude option. In transformation tab you will find the option to set coordinates and to set axis that we are going to use to trim the gumball extrusion part from our geometry. This option may not work properly in Rhino 6 or earlier versions. So you need to be working in later versions of Rhino for it to work correctly. Next, we can join the surfaces together again as a whole. Use cap holes option to close the volume. To make the edges on the surface smoother, we can use fillet edge command. Enter the radius of the fillet. Again, use select curve command to select all curves in the project and delete them. The last thing to do is to create fins or panels from the volume that we have by using contour command. Draw the reference for the axis and define the gap or the distance between these contours. We get these profile lines defining all contours and let's extrude them using extrude curve command. Define the thickness and that's how we can create these fins or panels for our parametric wall. We can delete the geometry we made before and make a group of these fins geometry. I hope you have learned some new techniques through our Rhino modeling tutorial. You can check out more such tutorials from our Rhino Grasshopper tutorial playlist. Make sure you subscribe to our channel for more upcoming videos on modeling and rendering. Thanks for watching. See you next time.